Now, we all know if you've got a valuable collection, you keep it somewhere safe. Stamps go in albums, jewels go in vaults. But what if you collect something that's much, much bigger? We're heading to Hertfordshire to check out a super-sized safety deposit box. This industrial estate looks like any other. It's full of big grey sheds, like this one. But uninvited visitors aren't welcome, although my drones have special access. Something tells me this place is worth a look. This is Studio 434. Its five air-conditioned floors are as protected as the Bank of England.
Security is the best. It's monitored 24 hours. I would comfortably say it's impossible to actually get in there.
Ultimate security for the ultimate man cave. Lamborghinis, Aston Martins, Ferraris, a motorhead's dream. At the last count, there were 423 cars, and the whole lot belongs to just one man, Roger Dudding.
We are told that we have the largest private collection in Europe. How true that is, one doesn't know. My attraction to motor cars is nearly always down to the design and the originality of the design.
Roger's the Willy Wonka of cars. That's how we'll sum him up. It doesn't necessarily have to be a Ferrari, a Lamborghini, or a Rolls-Royce. If it's something he particularly likes, he will buy it.
You look upon these things very much as fine art. They are three-dimensional art. The only trouble with motor cars versus a painting or postage stamps or handbags, whatever the case is, they do take up an enormous amount of room.
Roger's not short of space, and he's not short of cash either. He found his fortune during a trip to a Swedish patisserie in the early 60s.
I'd go off to the local baker, and there's a common thing there for you to be issued a numbered disc, signify yourself in the queue. So I thought that was rather unhygienic, and particularly for a country like Sweden, or most Scandinavian countries are very clinically clean, I thought of the idea of a one-way paper ticket. So when the customer entered the shop, they took a ticket, signified their position in the line, and then the paper ticket was discarded.
Roger's ticketed queuing systems can still be found in bakers and delis today. His car collection began with this humble runaround.
This Morris Minor, worth probably £6,000 or £7,000 in the marketplace. To me, it's absolutely priceless. For one simple reason, it belonged to my father, who ordered this new. If you offered me £5 million, I wouldn't sell it.
But one car led to another.
My late wife, Gloria, was getting rather fed up with my cluttering up the driveway with my ever-expanding number of vehicles, which then led me to looking for some premises.
More space meant more cars. But ever the entrepreneur, Roger found a way of making his hobby pay for itself.
We've become the one-stop shop for the film and prop companies. We've pretty much supplied cars to all the major period dramas, whether it's Downton Abbey, Peaky Blinders, Mr. Selfridge. It's just endless, endless.
Today, Louis and his team are expecting Roger's latest acquisition, a soft top with one lady owner.
Very recently, we had the opportunity to buy an Audi, which had been previously owned and used by the late Princess Diana. And I thought that was a car very much worth buying to maintain for history.
The Audi will be in good company.
So we have Princess Diana's Audi, drop-head convertible, and we have Dodi Fayed's Wedge Lagonda. It's two cars belonging to two iconic people.
The Aston Martin Lagonda was a love-it-or-hate-it car. It seems Roger was rather keen.
Launched in the late 70s, they were more expensive than a Rolls-Royce at that time. I bought my first one in, I think it was 81 or 82, drove it home, and my wife Gloria took one look at it and said, "That's absolutely horrible, sell it." Well, I love my Lagonda, so I kept it. And that's developed into the situation that up until last year, we had amassed 24.
You heard that right. He's got 24 Lagondas. So when will Roger decide that he's got enough cars?
Well, I don't think there can be too many. There's such a wide variety. To date, we've confined ourselves primarily to buying European cars, but I would like to extend that into various of the American brands.
So with over 400 cars at his disposal, Roger's biggest problem is choosing which one to take home. Good choice.